Welcome back. So today we are going to learn a new facial feature. So last class you drew one eye with me, one eye a little bit more on your own, and then a pair of eyes completely on your own, looking at all those different details for those eyes. Now today we are going to learn something that everybody dreads, and that is going to be the nose. It's also one of the hardest things to draw, but I am going to try to make this a little bit easier for you so that you have a great idea of how to do this. So just like our last thing that we drew, which is our eyes, we started with three circles. We're gonna start with three circles for the nose also. So I'm gonna have you follow along with me, and we're gonna do two noses. So you're gonna do one big circle and then two smaller circles. Now you can change how this looks. Maybe you have a circle and these on the sides are a little further away. Maybe they're a little bit bigger. So you're gonna get to decide how that nose looks. And we're just starting with two. Yeah, we'll keep those bigger. Now that we have our three circles to get started, we can actually really start to look at our nose. So if we look at our nose in the mirror, you have one big circle in the center, and that's the ball of your nose. And then these two on the side are your nostrils. So we're gonna make almost a smiley face when we start drawing our nose. We're gonna start at the bottom. Some people are rounded, mine is a little bit more flat, and it comes on up, and I have my nostrils. Now I'm looking at how big my nostrils are. We all have different sized nostrils. It's nothing to be embarrassed by. Again, I'm really looking in the mirror while I'm doing this, trying to figure out where those nostrils go. Now, if you just want to follow along, that's okay too. Now that I have my nose holes, I can actually start figuring out where the skin goes around that nostril. So notice I'm drawing like a semicircle with a nice little gap around it. And everybody's nose is different. Mine actually dips in a little bit right here and starts going up towards the top. And that's where I have my nose. I know it looks like a really weird character, but say this nose is a little bit wider. Maybe I have this one wider with a little bit less nostril showing, a little bit less nostril. And then again, I can use this to figure out where that nose would start and how it would come up. Maybe this is a little bit more of a wide nose. I know, and they look so strange without any eyes or any other kind of context. So what I want you to do is, since you did the first one with me, go ahead and do the second nose. You do want to make sure that not only does your nose have all of its details, so that means your nostrils and the ball of the nose, but it also has the bridge or the long part of the nose going up. I know, I think I just made that nose look funny. Now, you have two options. You can try down here to draw your nose exactly and add a little value, or you can do your nose and a little one to the side. So I'm gonna try to do one to the side for those who wanna do that, or kind of 3/4. I'm gonna start with the ball of my nose, and I'm gonna look to see where that nostril is. And I can already see that my nostril overlaps just a little bit, and I get just a little bit on that side. So I can start by looking at the contour of my nose. So this is actually gonna come up, and because it's over to the side, I'm only gonna see a little bit of that nostril or that nose hole, and I'm not really gonna see any of it on that side. So I'm gonna follow my nose, it's a little rounded, then I have a little bit of a bridge because I broke my nose twice, and then it goes up, and it connects to those eyebrows. So I can even see where my nostril would go here, following around that area, and then up, and then it goes into just value here, and I would have a little bit of that nostril. So if I wanted to erase some of my lines that I started with, you can really start to see how this looks like a nose. And again, that value is what's gonna take this from 2D to 3D. Now, I'm not showing you anything crazy with value just yet, but I am giving you an idea of how this can change are items. Now, again, I want to go ahead and try to draw my nose. So my ball of my nose is a little bit smaller. My nostrils are actually quite close. So I can figure out I have just a little platform. It comes up and over. Up and over. And then again, I'm going to follow that skin around my nostrils. Sometimes you have a lot of skin, sometimes you don't. And then all the way up. From the front, my nose looks quite large, and that's okay. And then coming up to those eyebrows, just to give you an idea of where those facial features would go. And then that value is what really shapes your nose. So letting me know, ooh yeah, there's a dark side right here. I can see where it indents on the sides, where it also would be darker where those eyes are. For ladies who contour, or gentlemen who contour, no judgment, we know that it's lighter towards the center of our nose. And look at how with this value, we can really start to see this nose take off and start to look a little bit more like a nose. I look forward to seeing what you're putting down, and we'll move on to our next box next class. Remember, these are due Friday.